Namaste all, and welcome to the final week of our Wisdom of Mindfulness series. All month long, we have been focusing on the key of mindfulness as a way to strengthen our spiritual faculty of wisdom. We started with the wisdom of the heart, where we did a heart activation meditation. We were really able at that point to expand our heart space and allow love in, and allow our hearts to guide us. Not for us to try to guide our hearts or to protect our hearts, because our hearts don't need protecting. Our hearts know long before us what's going on around us. It can really tell us how we need to move through the experiences that we have. Along with that, I gave you guys homework called the daily routine. And so that was to take one of your daily activities that you do on a regular basis, but do it mindfully each day. To choose one activity, for instance, making tea, drinking coffee, brushing your teeth, or brushing your hair, whatever it was, whatever you normally do on a daily basis, but being very mindful and present in that complete activity, not focusing on anything else, not trying to multitask or anything like that, and see what came up for you in that. The second week, we talked about the wisdom of the body, understanding that our body is always imparting wisdom to us, our physical bodies as well as our energetic bodies. So we did a full body scan meditation that week so that we can just really pay attention to each and every part of our body, what knowledge and wisdom that body part was trying to share. Then I encouraged you all to try it on your own, whether it was a full body scan meditation or an upper or lower body scan meditation. And then along with that, I gave you homework for that week, the five senses activity, where I asked you to focus on five things that you can see, four things that you can touch, three things that you can hear, and two things that you can taste, and one thing that you can smell. That activity should have taken you about 12 to 15 minutes because you focus on those things I gave you 1 minute each. And just allow yourself to be present in the moment with those things. Be amazed at what you recognize that you normally didn't in those activities that you did on a daily basis. Giving you an opportunity to pay attention, be aware. And then last week was a doozy. We did the wisdom of the self, the wisdom of acknowledging the truth of who we are. So we did a body, mind, and emotion meditation where we were acknowledging and being very aware of what our mind and our body and our emotions in conjunction with each other were telling us and being grateful at what we were being shown. And then for your homework, I asked each and every one of you to do mindfulness mirror work. And that was to stand in front of a mirror in your birthday suit, right? No clothes on, just you by yourself, nobody else there. And honor yourself. Honor your body, honor your skin, honor your hair, honor your curves, honor your muscles, whatever it is that you have. Honoring and loving all of who you are. Honoring the person that you have become. You know, we've all gone through many challenges in our lives, and some of us have had some deep, deep trauma. But we've all gone through something. And we've had to move through. And guess what? We are still standing. We are still sitting here as beautiful expressions of spirit. So this was to help us recognize our growth and our need for more growth, and honoring in ourselves what we have learned, the wisdom we have gained, how we have grown. And then I asked you to do some affirmations to yourself in the mirror, right there while you're standing there. Some affirmations on what you see, how you want to move through, what you want for your life, whatever desires you have to help you to continue to grow and become the best expression of spirit. And then along with that, I asked you to honor that little child within, your inner child that may have had to go through those traumas, the little child that had all those wonderful dreams, and let that child know that they are loved. They've not done anything wrong. And whatever they had to do, whatever defenses they had built up in their little minds to protect themselves was okay. But now you, this big, beautiful, strong, courageous, and confident adult, are here to take care of them. And so that's what I wanted you guys to do, that mirror work, to stand in that mirror, acknowledge the beauty of who you are completely and totally. So hopefully you did all those things, or you at least tried them. And then I wanted you to journal about it. Journal about what came up. Write it down. Sometimes we think about what came up, what happened. But writing stuff down, we find that there was more than what we realized. So this week, we're going to be talking about the wisdom of nature and how you can connect with spirit through nature. One of the things that being mindful in nature allows us to do is take in the contemplative beauty, wonder, and awe of nature. We're able, when we do this, to see the characteristics of nature around us and how they are similar, or how they can be similar, to what we want to do, what we need to do, or what we do in life. For example, being near water, we're able to see the nature of water, the strength of water, the non-resistance of water, the purification of water. All those things we can sit and contemplate and just be mindful of and watch. You're just seeing the ebb and flow of the water without judgment. Because, you know, we don't sit by the water and look at the water and the ebb and flow and say, hey, I've seen better ebbs and flows. It's just the ebb and flow. So being able to just do that and be in the moment with that allows the distractions of what's going on in our external and outer world to just fall away, so that we can connect with our inner selves and connect with the characteristics of nature and take them in for ourselves. But there's also a healing quality to nature. Just the quality of the air that you breathe. Just the ability to remove yourself from the artificial sounds that are always all around you. And just listen to the beautiful sounds of nature. Just allow your eyes to be desensitized from that blue screen that you're always looking at on your computer or your phone or your tablet or your TV. You're constantly connected to, and instead being connected with the natural colors of nature, the combo of colors that sometimes we didn't even know was possible. The ability to take a look at the natural shapes that you can see out of nature, it all allows those healing qualities to help you bathe in the healing energy that is all around you. And so when you can do this mindfully and be in the presence, because, you know, it's always about practicing being in the present now moment, we can recognize that all the things that we worry about, all the things that we stress about are not necessarily that important. What's important is you being here in nature, being alive and being able to experience it all and to be part of it. And to know that you are bigger than the problems that you see. You are bigger than the challenges that you face. You are bigger than the illusions that you create for yourself. Because you are a part of this wondrous nature that is all around us. It is our connectedness to this nature that helps us to see past the illusions of this world that we're living in. You know, some people say that this breathing, you know, we breathe in and we breathe in what the flowers and the plants have breathed out. and vice versa. And you know that you're breathing out what the plants and flowers are breathing in. But that still denotes some sort of separation instead of our connectedness and our oneness with all there is. The truth is, as you're breathing in, nature's breathing in. All is breathing in because we are all one. So that's the truth of nature. And that's what being mindful of in nature reminds us of, that we are part of this something bigger. Bigger than the challenges that you face. And you cannot be reduced. And you cannot reduce yourself to the challenges or to the situations that are happening around you. At this moment, it gives you the opportunity to recognize that you are part of this vast universe that is constantly growing and expanding. It allows you to say, I'm not going to argue for my limitations. Right? Because that's what we do. Right? We argue for our limitations. No, I can't because I'm not tall enough or short enough. I'm not skinny enough or fat enough. I'm old. I'm not young enough. I'm not smart enough. I don't have the education. We are constantly arguing for our limitations. I'm not lovable. This person can't love me or whatever. None of that matters. We need to stop arguing for our limitations and start stepping forward into our greatness, into who we truly are. And when we're able to be mindful with nature, when we're able to see that, to see that we are bigger than all of that, that we are part of this vast, beautiful world, and that we are connected to the allness and the oneness, regardless of the challenges we face, that's when we heal. That's when we grow. That's when we're able to take in all of the wisdom that nature has to offer. And that's when you recognize your greatness. But until you recognize who you are, until you're able to sit and be at one with yourself and be okay with who you are, none of it matters. What anybody else does not matter. The only thing that matters is who you are and how you choose to show up in the world. Because how you show up is what's going to affect everything else. It is your frequency and energy and vibration that you put out that affects all of your experiences. So take the time to be mindful in nature and treat yourself well. Put yourself as a priority, because if you don't put yourself as a priority, how can you expect anybody else to? You're going to do exactly what you do. You don't make yourself a priority, then they won't make you a priority. You need to stand in your own truth. Know your greatness. And know that you're okay. And know that if that person is not showing the love, and if you're focused on you not getting the love from that person, you might be missing the love and encouragement and support of the many other people that are showing it to you because you're so myopically focused on one person, on one situation, or one thing. So instead, follow the example of nature and be open to all that is. Be open. That's what nature reminds us. Do you know how many different species of flowers and plants and grass and trees and birds and insects there are? No, you don't. And you won't ever come close to even understanding or knowing if you don't allow yourself to be mindfully present in nature. Mindfully present to what's right in front of you. Instead of focusing on what has happened in the past or being fearful about what may happen in the future or worrying about what somebody else thinks, does, or says. That's what mindfulness of nature does for you. So, homework for week number 4 is a mindfulness walk in nature. I want you to do a mindfulness walk, if possible. If you could find a park or maybe in your subdivision or neighborhood, anything like that, and really take a mindful walk. Now that means you're not focused on anything else. You're not listening to anything else. No, we don't have our earphones in. We don't have music on. We're not listening to a book or whatever else that we normally do. We're just really taking a mindful walk in nature. This is not a walk for exercise either, so we're not pumping our arms, we're not trying to get steps in, we're not counting any of that or how far we're going, nothing. It's just allowing yourself to be in nature, allowing yourself to be very present where you are, so that you can see all the wonders of nature around you. You know, like sometimes if you are driving the same route every day, you're driving here, you're driving there, and next thing you know, you're a passenger in the car. And you're like, wow, I didn't know that that was there. Or I didn't see that before. Well, that's because you're not having to focus on everything. You're not having to focus on the traffic, on driving, on the traffic lights, on pedestrians, on honking, anything like that. As a passenger, you're able to be more mindful in your seat and pay attention to where, what is going on and what you're seeing all around you. That's what I want you to do with this walk. Not be focused on how many steps or how far you're going or any music or anything like that or how long it took. Just be in nature and allow yourself to bathe in the wisdom and the healing energy that's all around you. Allow yourself to see what's going on, to smell the wonderful aromas of the leaves and the flowers. Allow yourself to see how many other butterflies you can encounter. Allow yourself to find whatever little creek or river there may be, something you didn't notice before. Just be one with it and allow the healing to take place. You will soon recognize how calm your body will become, how much more peaceful your mind will be, and how much healing will be going on inside of you. That's why I always tell you, you know, to hug a tree. Hug a tree. And I allow that tree to heal me. So if you want to try that, do that as well. First, acknowledge the tree and ask if it's okay for you to hug them. And then allow that tree to heal you, to take all of the stress and anxiety away. Allow it to cleanse you. Remind you that you are one with all that there is. And then in turn, love the tree. Allow the tree to be a tree. Say how beautiful and strong and flexible, how much the tree is wondrous to you. See how the tree is not worrying about anything else but being a tree. And allow the tree to take whatever stress and anxiety away from you that there is. And then thank the tree for being there and doing its perfect work. Now, you can do that with anything. If you choose to put your feet in some wonderful grass, or step your feet in the river or on a beach or in sand or anything like that, allow yourself to feel that and allow the feeling to heal you. Be very still and mindful in that. So that's what I'd like you to do. If you can do that 3 times this week for maybe 15 minutes or so, it doesn't have to be long. Take that mindful walk in nature. You could do it before you do your regular exercise, or you could do it afterwards as part of your cool down. You do it at your lunchtime on your 15-minute break or whatever it is. Go outside and be mindful. That means we're not speeding, we're not rushing, we're not taking our phones necessarily, or we're putting it on silent so it's not distracting us. And just do that walk. And of course, do any of the other exercises that we have done in this mindfulness series. I encourage you to either continue to do it or to try something new. You gotta be open to trying different things because you never know what's gonna resonate with you. You never know what is going to work for you. And it may be different from one moment to the next. Maybe something else will open up for you. You will encounter something else that you can try and you can do that will help you gain the wisdom from the universe, from spirit, from nature, from self. So take the opportunity to participate in any of these or any other mindfulness activities that you encounter. Be courageous enough to try. And then make sure you journal about it. See what comes up for you and what wisdom being revealed to you.